students, I am here with the new lesson, new sociology lesson, that is family. Chapter 1st, family. Yes, we know that man is a social being, is it? Man is a human being as well as he is a social being. Without the society, he cannot live, is it? So, this basic thing we already learned in the 8th standard, is it? Yes, then we can forward that. The family is the very necessary. Man has formed the many social institutions, is it? So what are the social institutions? Family, marriage, society, school, is it? So all these we call what it is, a social institution, is it? So man has formed the many more social institutions for what purpose? For fulfill his basic needs, is it? To fulfill his basic needs. So on these, so family is also one of the social institution. Understand? Man has formed the many more social institution. On these, family is also one of the what is main social institution. By the family, he fulfill his basic need. So family is the one of the social institution, it is the basic social institution, is it? So all social activities are conducted by the family only. Understand? All social activities are conducted by the family only. So likewise, the group of the people living in the family, then the group of the families are called village, the group of the village are called the taluk or patanas, the group of the patanas is called the taluk, the group of the taluk is called the district, the group of the districts is called what it is, state, the group of the state is called the country, the group of the country is called continent, and the group of the continents is called the world, is it? So what we learn here, the base for the world is what it is, society, sorry, family, is it? Base for the world is a society. So all basic activities of the society is conducted by the family. The family is the base for the society, is it? Then all family members are also the members of the society. Yes, after the definition, we will clear about the meaning of family. Understand this? Yes, let us discuss about that. How the word family is derived. Family, this word is derived from the families. The word family is derived from the families. Families, it means what? To serve. What is it? To serve. The word family is derived from the word families. Families, it means to serve. Yes, it is nothing but here in a family, the father, mother or husband and wife live with his children or without the children is called the family. Yes, in last, in a sense, olden days we can see that the father and mother live with the other people. Is it uncle, aunt, is it grandmother, grandfather, so great-grandmother, great-grandfather. So likewise we can see in the olden days, but nowadays it is not possible to see this type of the family. But the parents, in the sense the father and mother live with the people, with the children or without the children, is we consider as the family. Understand? Sometimes these peoples are adopt some children and adopt the children. So this is called the family. Understand this? What it is? The word family is derived from the word the families. Families means to serve. Here the elders, is it? Then afterwards, youngers also we can see in the family. So all peoples are there in the family. Father, mother, brother, sister, son, wife. We can see that the many more peoples are there. So they have their own responsibilities and role in the family. Understand this? So likewise, what is the general meaning of the family? The general meaning of the family means the father and mother living with the children or without the children is called the family. Understand this? Yes, we can see here that the family is bonded by the kinship. What is the kinship? Is it? It is a new word to you. Kinship, it means the blood relation. Is it? Yes, So take your example for your family. The who are living in your family, you are all blood relations. Is it? You are all blood relations. In the sense, Rakta Sambandha. Is it? The people who are living in the family, those peoples are bonded by the blood relations and more than emotions. Understand? But it is the people living in the family, they are bonded by and this kinship and also the, in a sense, blood relation, then afterwards the emotion. Yes, we can see that the people are bonded by the blood relation and also the emotion, and they have their own roles and responsibilities. Is it? Yes, we can see in the family what is husband, wife, father, mother, son, daughter, is it? Sister, brother, is it? So likewise relationship we can see in the family, and these peoples have their own responsibility and roles. Is it? They play their own roles and also the responsibilities. Then we can see that these all people, what is father, mother, brother, sister, son, daughter, husband and wife, all these peoples are live under the same roof. Is it? But is all these members live under the same roof? Is it? So we call it is the family. Then another one definition is that is along with the father, mother, their married children or unmarried children, or with the children or without children, they live a long life is called the family, is the general definition. But it is in a family, the along with the father and mother, with the children or without children, living a long life is called what is a family. Understand that? Yes, likewise, already we discussed about that, the these family members are bonded by the blood relation and also the emotions. And we can see that these family members is the second main function is the nurturing of the people. What is nurturing the children is the main important function after the blood relationship. Then their roles, then the next important function of the family is the nurturing the children. Is it? So they give the good direction to children and they give the good socialization to those children to live in the society. Is it? So for that purpose, they involve those children in the socialization process. Afterwards, they teach to how to behave with the others. By this, the children learn how to behave and about the rituals and the many more issues. All this the children learn from the family. So in olden days, we can see that nowadays is also mane modala patashale tai tane modala guru. Is it? So likewise, socialization process of the children is started by the family. Afterwards, only he is become the very perfect to live in the society. Okay, this is all about the introduction and the small general meaning of the family. Understand? The family means father, mother with the, his children or without children living together in the long period. In the long period is called what? It is a family. Nowadays, these father and mother are also adopt the children. Is it? It is also new concept we can see in the family nowadays. Okay, this is all about the introduction of family. Yes, let us discuss about that, the characteristics of family. Family is universal and it is the basic unit for all social activities. And continuous responsibility and social accountability. Then bringing up and nurturing and teaching social behavior, and it instruct the traditions. Yes, these are all the characters of the family. Afterwards only it is possible to understand the importance of the family. Let us discuss about one by one. Family is universal. Yes, in the world we can see the family. Is it? So we cannot see there isn't a no society, there isn't a no family. Is it? Is it? It is the two coins of the single face. It is the two faces for a single coin. Is it? So likewise, according to the geographical situation, we can see, and during that period we can see that every society have its own family. In a sense, every society have the family. Already we know that the family is basic for about all social activities, is it? Then all family have their own same pattern, is it? So in all family, in the variety place, in the varieties of the country, we can see that every family have its functions like the marriage, nurturing, then afterwards the property right, kinship, is it? So all these things we can see in the all family, is it? Yes, in our Karnataka we can see that the kinship, property right, then kinship, property right, then afterwards what we can see that the marriage, is it? All these things we can see in the Karnataka family. So similarly in the Kashmir, similarly in the America, similarly in the Pakistan, is it? So these are all the main functions and activities of the every family. So family is universal. All over the world we can see the family. Yes, and it is the basic unit for all social activity. Yes, the family is the basic unit for the all social activity. Already we know that all basic activity are all based by the family only. In the during the early period, the family members are sent their member. The family, one family is sent its member for the social activity. Is it? So, involving the social activity. Nowadays, the society is very complex now. For that purpose, we can see that this responsibility and duties are, we can see that it is includes in the varieties of social institution. Is it? So, yes, the next one is the continuous responsibility and social accountability. Yes, here the family teaches the children to how to behave and how to interact with the society and how to discharge their responsibility in the society. All these things the children learn in the society. Then also that here the family gives the people, the family is narrate the children. Afterwards it gives the language. Afterwards it gives the particular, what is it, rituals for the children. Through that, the children follow all these activity along with his development, is it? Then afterwards, it teach about the friendship, kinship, how to behave with the neighbors, is it? So likewise, all these things we learn in the family. So it narrate the children as well as it also take care of the elders in the old age, is it? So it narrate the nurturing the children, afterwards the old age peoples also. Continuous responsibility and social accountability is also one of the main function or the characteristic of the family. Yes, here the people who are the member of the family, they learn how to behave in the society and how to discharge their responsibility in the society. Then afterwards they learn about that how to interact with others, how to behave with the others. Understand this. Then afterwards we can see that they get the social responsibility, how to they manage the social responsibility. So for example, how to keep the drinking water clean, is it? So likewise all things we can see that what is these responsibilities we are getting by this family only. This is the main characteristics of the family. Then next one is the bringing up and nurturing. Bringing up and nurturing is the main basic function, is the basic characteristic of the family. Understand this? Yes, here the children get the nurturing in the family and they are all get the protection by the family. Through that they get the education in the family and they get socialization in the family. Not only for the children, and the family is take care of the old elder in their old age. Understand? Yes. Then next is the teaches the social behavior. Yes, the family is one of the social, it gives the socialization to children. Then afterwards we can see that it teach the people how to behave in the society. It teach the its members how to behave with the elders and how to behave with the neighbors, is it? So all these things we can see in the family only. Then afterwards we can see that in the family they learn about the how to discharge their responsibility in the family and also the society also. Then they are all bonded by the emotion and kinship. For that purpose, we can see the extraordinary understanding they are also learned in the family only. Then the family teaches the children. Afterwards, it brings its members in the good path also. Then afterwards we see that it teach the children about the freedom and the security during the period of adolescence, childhood, is it? And afterwards in all its developmental stages, is it? It teach about the freedom and security. By this, the child learn more thing in the family. Afterwards, it learn its mother tongue in the family. By that, it understand the word. Understand? So, all this is about the teacher's social behavior.